Hello, everyone. This is a description of the four areas of the cerebral cortex. They are the frontal lobe, the parietal lobe, the occipital lobe, and the temporal lobe. If you're looking at the figure, the frontal lobe is actually behind your forehead, right where your eyes are, and the occipital lobe is at the back of your head. So we can start there. The occipital lobe, the function of the occipital lobe is vision, basically, and that's it. It's dedicated to our ability to see. The parietal lobe, the function of the parietal lobe, it has to do with your sensory functions, and then also it's really important for perception of three-dimensional space. And this has to do with visual perception of three-dimensional space, but also three-dimensional space that isn't specific to vision. So if you imagine someone who's blind, who doesn't have vision, absolutely has an understanding of three-dimensional space and where we are in space. Let's see, your temporal lobe is important for lots of things. It's important for your ability to hear. It's important for recognition and identification of objects. So object recognition, face recognition, things like that, knowing who different people are. Let's see, it's also important for language, language comprehension. It's important for memory as well. So not so much that our memories are stored there. Our memories are stored throughout our brain, but the temporal lobe is important for the aspect of memory that's involved in creating new memories and then recalling things that we've experienced before. So it's important in the process of memory. Let's see, and then lastly, the frontal lobe is important for things like planning and sequencing behavior. So knowing what you want to do and when, right? And sequencing in terms of things like even if you wanted to, like let's say when you get up in the morning, you'd like to eat some breakfast, you'd like to get dressed, you'd like to take a shower. So knowing that that it's probably a good idea to take the shower first and then get dressed. That would be sequencing. And then it's also important in things like understanding consequences of your behavior. It's important in, it has a lot to do with your own personality. Let's see, in processing of emotion. Frontal lobe is very important for processing of emotion. And then also speech. There's an area of your frontal lobe that's critical for speech. And then also right by the parietal lobe, if you see there, so there's a strip that's at the back end of the frontal lobe, almost where it goes to the yellow there of the parietal lobe. And that area is really important for motor movements. And so that strip there that goes right up against the parietal lobe is where all of the commands are sent from to move any part of your body. So hopefully that's a good explanation of the four lobes.